Good afternoon, school. The Lord be with you. I know many of you are tired of being stuck at home. I am. I've watched everything of slight interest on Netflix, and the fact that driving to Dis-Chem and Checkers is considered an outing shows how small my world has become. I'm not wallowing in self-pity, as I know there are millions of people who are many, many times worse off than I am, and the majority of you are better off too. But just for today, I'd like to take you out of that claustrophobic world. We moved to the St. Albans Chapel all the way to Egypt. This is where the Israelites were enslaved by the Egyptians. Exodus 11 and 12 tell us that in an effort to try to free his people, God sent plagues. And just visualize how awful they must have been. They were water turning to blood, frogs, lice, flies, livestock illness, boils, hail, locusts, darkness, and the killing of firstborn children. Each time Pharaoh promised to free the Israelites, but reversed his decision when the plague was lifted, until the last one. So as to avoid having their firstborn children killed, God instructed Moses and Aaron to tell the Jews to slaughter a lamb and use the blood to make a cross on their doors. Exodus 13 tells us that God said, "The blood will be a sign for you on the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you. No destructive plague will touch you when I strike Egypt." This is called what we know today as the Passover. You can imagine how frightened the people must have been. I know how afraid I would have been if any of my children's lives were in danger. All they could do was to have faith that what the Lord had said would happen. Indeed, it did. The firstborns of the Jews were saved, while those of the Egyptians, animals and people, were killed. Shortly afterwards, the Jews were liberated from Egypt and were led on a difficult journey by Moses to the promised land of Canaan. There are two things on which I'd like us to focus. The first is faith. According to Hebrews 11 verse 1, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. In other words, a belief in something that cannot be seen or touched. Just as the Jews had to have faith that their firstborns would be spared, and that ultimately they'd be liberated from Egypt, so too do we need to have faith that God is looking out for us, and that in the end, things will work out. They will not necessarily go back to how they were before the pandemic. I'm not saying normal, because normal is a setting on a washing machine, but that we'll learn to accept a new way of being, new values, and new ways of interacting with each other. We need to have faith that this too shall pass. The other thing I'd like to talk about is the concept of freedom. Yes, we are stuck in our houses and can't see our friends, or go back to school, or travel, go to the movies, and for millions, work. But there is always freedom of the mind. Viktor Emil Frankl was an Austrian neurologist and psychiatrist, as well as a Holocaust survivor. He applied many of his experiences as a prisoner in the concentration camps, where conditions were dire, to his practice thereafter. In his book, Man's Search for Meaning, he says, "Everything can be taken from a man, but one thing, the last of the human freedoms, to choose one's attitude in any given circumstances, to choose one's own way." We need to choose our attitudes and engage with freedom of the mind. We should use our minds creatively to learn something new, improve relationships with family, reflect on our values and life choices, and to know that after darkness comes light. At the same time, we also need to be aware of what Susan Sontag says: our local individual actions are inextricably connected to and fractionally instrumental in our global collective fate. Our actions and state of minds affect the lives of many others around the world. Most important of all, we need to have faith in the power, love, and sustenance of God. Here is a video which inspires optimism.
soul. He's got a beast in his belly that's so hard to control. Cause they've taken too much hits, they go blow by blow. Now light him at stand back, watch him explode. She's got a lion in her heart, a fire in her soul. He's got a beast in his belly that's so hard to control. Cause they've taken too much hits, they go blow by blow. Now light him at stand back, watch him explode. Struggling to make things right, that's how a superhero learns to fly.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, the world is changing so fast. Every day the media relays tales of those who disregard law, devise evil, and destroy both people and property. And because of what's happening, fear sometimes rises up in our hearts, for us, for those we love, and for people everywhere. Yet we have faith that you are in control. I ask you today for your protection, Lord, both personally and globally. Please station angels around our homes and families to guard them from danger. Lead us away from temptation and help us to run from the presence of questionable activities or harmful influences. When we're weak, help us to look up to you and to hold on tightly to the truth that you love us and want the best for us. In your precious name, Amen. May the Lord be with you.